Roanoke-Blacksburg Regional Airport is losing an alarming number of flyers to other airports as they look for more affordable flights.
Airport leaders presented a roughly $9 million proposed budget to Roanoke City Council this afternoon, which is flat compared to last year. They say it's tough to plan for upgrades when they're losing riders to surrounding areas. WSLS 10's Bree Jackson is live at the airport. So Bree, what's the issue here? I would imagine it comes down to cost.
Well, Lindsay, the airport does not receive funding from the city or the county, so they rely on revenues to make improvements. And they say that last year they lost about 90,000 passengers to people that are flying out of surrounding airports. So they say in order to improve services here, they need to see more people flying locally. For some, the Roanoke-Blacksburg Regional Airport is a convenient way to fly.
I really like the airport. It's easy in and out. There's plenty of parking.
Others have found better deals elsewhere. Officials say that the airport loses close to 90,000 passengers a year to areas like Charlotte and Greensboro.
I can't get the airlines to the table.
Tim Bradshaw, the executive director of the Roanoke-Blacksburg Regional Airport, told local leaders that it's been a challenge trying to increase services due to shrinking revenues.
The airlines are very content with the level of service that they have here at Roanoke. Of course, we would like to have more flights, cheaper flights.
In order to do so, ridership must go up. Marketing officials at the airport say they cannot lower ticket prices, but they do plan to focus on the customer's experience. They hope improving service reliability encourages people to fly local.
There's no sense getting a flight from here to Charlotte if it's going to cancel and you're going to get bused down there or drive anyway. So we're trying to improve on that.
In addition, airport leaders are working with airlines to identify connection opportunities to the West Coast.
For example, we're trying to go to Dallas nonstop, and we have the passengers to support that service.
Bradshaw says on average about 130 people a day fly between Roanoke and Dallas. He says offering incentives, such as waiving landing fees, could help attract more flights. But in the end, it comes down to the numbers.
Really, air service is really dependent upon the consumer. If they buy the tickets, then the airplanes will come.
Moving forward, travelers we spoke with say while other airports may be appealing, they hope to see more people and more destinations come to Roanoke.
It'd be nice if they could go to more areas.
And local leaders tell me that moving forward, they do plan to talk with airlines about improving services and adding flights to Denver, Dallas, as well as Fort Lauderdale. They also tell me that what is in the budget is plans to add a canopy from the parking lot to the terminal to protect passengers. In Roanoke, Bree Jackson, WSLS 10.